secrets turn to pick.
Good evening, boys, girls, gentlemen, and anybody else who's joining us. Good evening, good afternoon, good night, whatever intro it is that you like. We're going to watch this game, Team Secret versus Bisofan. Should be a pretty good game in terms of watching Secret Advance. Only English cast in the lobby, surprisingly enough, so I'm going to make sure that I do it official. I do have my son here, so if he comes over and says hello, well, that's just the nature of the game, so bear with me, but I wanted to make sure that somebody was in lobby so that we could at least have English coverage on Dota TV. I'm sure this is being cast on delay somewhere. Probably my OD Pixel and the crew. I hope to God they don't use my camera because if my son runs over and grabs my mouse arm, things could get crazy. But I promise I'm going to do my best for you guys to bring you some phenomenal action here. So let's get right into it. The story tonight is a simple one. The boys just want to play Dota, and at the end of the day, that's what they're here for. Eternal Envy, Puppy, Bulba, Pilot Eye, and Arteezy are a couple of guys who just want to go to TI, and they're going to have to do it the hard way. They're going to have to go the long road, earn their way all the way through the open qualifiers, and that's exactly what they're working on right now. So we're going to keep an eye on them as they sort of prep themselves and move forward here. Now, that said, I think that the team, we know that we've seen some changes, right? We saw the departure of some players, particularly Universe, who had come over recently to return to EG. They traded basically with Bulba to come here, and it's an interesting argument that hasn't been made is the idea that in other sports like the NBA, trades happen all the time. Teams aren't penalized for it if both teams contractually agree to a trade. So there is a discussion to say, well, if Secret agrees to take Bulba and EG agrees to take Universe, why are we punishing both teams? Now, that's because of Valve standards, Valve rules. That said, both teams, neither of them fought it tooth and nail. They very graciously relegated themselves to the open qualifiers and will be playing through it on both counts. So good on them for being willing to do that.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
By the way, guys, the stream's already cut. Never mind. So that's it. Back to the track here is the storyline of the game is very, very simple. They're going to fight their way through it. So far, they have been doing it dynamically and very, very well. And I've been super impressed with their ability to sort of keep it together and very comfortably push through. Easy, some people made fun of him for having a tough first game. But hey, it's a warm-up and open. And the one risk you have with opens is underestimating your opponents. Because Secret comes in as one of the favorite teams to do well at TI, to be completely honest. I like the new lineup. I think Bulba's going to fit well with Puppy and Envy and their personalities, but they got to get through this. And any given Sunday, you can be beaten by pro teams, but any given Saturday, by a cheese strat or being caught off guard or being overconfident, you can find yourself in the pits of hell when it comes to open qualifiers. And that's something that these guys have to be very, very careful of in terms of Team Secret. They don't want to get caught with their pants down. So Puppy, it looks like, is still staying very consistent with his draft, making sure that his boys know exactly what they need and are getting what they need out of this whole thing. Let's see here, make sure that the delay is set correctly. Team ban. 240.
Team Secret's turn to ban. Five seconds remaining.
All right, we had to readjust. Those of you who maybe just came back a little while ago, we had to match the required delay on Dota TV. So we did have to wait 5 minutes. So I appreciate you guys sticking around during that time. But this should be a pretty good match. And I'm excited about watching it and sort of being in it for this whole process. Now, Faceless Void and Bane are both picked up early. Good picks for Bisofan. They both supply what you are going to need against a team like Secret, and that is control. Secret is going to bring aggression. They're going to bring players who are have absolute, and this is the key. They have absolute mastery, and I don't use that in any simple terms, absolute mastery of their positions. They're some of the best players in the entire world. So the only way to deal with that is cheese or control. And it looks like the Dire is looking for control to be the tactic that they use to make sure that these guys don't get out of hand. On the opposite side, Puppy is very clearly putting thought into this draft. I predict that he will utilize two things during the opens. One, sure bets, but B, he'll also test out some things, maybe one hero at a time, that he hopes they can use further on down the road. He's maybe a little bit likely to use that early on against teams that are a bit smaller than later in the qualifiers, going up against teams that are bigger and a lot harder to deal with. But we'll see sort of where that takes them. Right now, it's clear that he's taking his time. Elder Titan and Beastmaster are picked up early. He got rid of the bounty. He doesn't want to deal with an alchemist. He doesn't like the invisibility heroes. So that means that he wants someone who can't disjoint, who can't just disappear when the fight breaks out. They know that there's going to be a lot of chance for these teams to beat them using avoidance strategies, and they're not going to allow that in any way, shape, or form. They're also going to take away the vision potential. They get the Beastmaster for themselves, and they take away the two invisible scouts, which means that Bisufan, I don't know how to say it, are really going to be effectively working from a much more blind position on the map than the guys from Team Secret will ever be able to handle.
Team Secrets.
Gyrocopter gets picked up by Bisufan. I'm not sure how I feel about that, to be completely honest with you. It's an okay pick, but
Dire team pick.
It's I don't know. I think that he has a good online time. The problem for me with the Gyrocopter in the hands against Team Secret is if you bring him online where your normal tier 2, tier 3 team even would bring him online, compared to Team Secret's general farm and GPM counts, it's nowhere near where it needs to be competitive. If he comes online at, say, 22 minutes, you're going to be so far behind at that point that you're not going to have the ability to really use his first uptime. Then he goes into sort of a farming doldrum for about 10 more minutes and then comes back into the late game. The problem is, if you lose that middle, your late game is going to be well after the Drow Ranger and the Beastmaster are really taking it to you. Tinker gets picked up to go head-to-head with an Invoker. That does allow them some mobility on the map and some potential split push. The problem is, if anybody is qualified to take down the Tinker on the outside, it's Team Secret. They're going to know where he's going. They've got players who are experts at picking off these heroes and these split pushers. All right, I said my son might come over, so it looks like he's going to join us for a minute. He's coming to say hi. Better now than later, my friend. Better now than later. All right, so the Witch Doctor is banned out. They know that a support is necessary in that final position. They do not like the way the Witch Doctor's ultimate works. The Bouncing Cask of Doom is too unpredictable. And it seems like what Puppy really enjoys is not having to deal with RNG, not having to deal with unknown components when it comes to large fights breaking out. And that's what you do when you get rid of the invisible heroes, when you get rid of the Phoenix, when you get rid of sort of the RNG from the Witch Doctor. You take out the possible things that could go wrong and focus on the things that are going to go right. Griffin, you got to stop making so much noise, homie.
Dire team pick.
All right, we're almost 5 minutes in, so it's such a long delay. Lich now gets picked up, final for Bisufan. That's going to try to buy some space for Tinker. I think it's a really great pickup for them. It is going to have some trouble with the bouncing. Obviously, the Beastmaster and the Invoker are both going to have summonables out pretty aggressively in this game. And the Lich will not exert as much damage with the ultimate on the heroes, but it may kill off some of the summonables. More importantly, however, this is 100% why they took him. He's got a strong harass out of lane, and he's got a very good chance of at least giving Tinker a chance to go head to head with Arteezy, because what you're looking at is your Tinker, your mid is going head to head with one of the best, if not the best, player in the world. And that's something that you really do have to be aware of as you prep yourself for this sort of stuff. Isn't it live? One second, I want to make sure the stream is running okay.
Seconds remaining.
Five seconds I made a stream. Remaining. The delay is really long. Too long. An extra minute longer than it needs to be. Yep, there we go. All right, so if you're watching this, the delay is a little bit longer than it is on Dota TV. I apologize for that. Feel free to watch Dota TV, though, and get the voice if that's what you really want. But here we go. We're jumping right into it now. It is go time, boys and girls, for this matchup between Biz and Team Secret in the open qualifiers for TI Europe. My name's Toffees. It's Toffees TV. Let's settle in and have some fun. All right, introductions for the two teams while we have our pods out on the map. Starting out with Biz fans over on the Dire side. We are going to have F playing the Gyrocopter. We're going to have the Lich played by none other than... Where'd he go here? Played by none other than Toto. We're going to have Gluttony playing that Void. We're going to have STR bringing it home on the Bane. And last but not least on that side, Marone is going to be playing the in the mid against the lineup from Team Secret. It is going to be Eternal Envy on the Drow Ranger, the Captain Puppy on the Elder Titan, apropos choice, if I may say so myself, Mulva, the newest member, bringing home the Beastmaster. We're going to have the Shadow Fiend played by none other than Pilotai. And last but certainly not least, one of the best mids in the world is going to be Invoker played by RTZ. My name's Toffees, as I said. Let's get this thing underway. Well, or not. There comes the pause again. Wouldn't be Dota without a pause. Eternal Envy and RTZ looking like they want to start to cause a little bit of trouble here. Alright, we're gonna go head-to-head on the runes. Both Secret gonna just go ahead and manhandle the bottom rune. No contest whatsoever. Biz is too scared to go in and get the top one, so they might actually let Bulba just come in and get it by himself. The battle begins. He's playing careful. He's hoping that they don't gank him, so he does want to make sure he's not caught in an awkward position. And like we said, that's one of the keys to winning. You know you can win on strict mechanics alone, so it is imperative that you are able to effectively accomplish your goals in another capacity, that you really can follow, can make sure that you live, can make sure that you take out heroes and objectives carefully and very, very strongly. All right, lining up here in the mid position is going to be Marone and RTZ. They're going to be head to head. Marone is going to have a difficult lane. That's something that doesn't need to be stated. He's already down at half his health as he just takes shot after shot from RTZ, who just manages that creep equilibrium so effectively. The creeps finally go to the low ground, but they bring him right up for vision, so he's going to go after him again. Cold snaps off in 5 seconds. If he's not careful, that will be a first blood for RTZ. He knows he wants it. He's waiting. He knows he doesn't have the skill level. He's got his cold snap available. He's got an EMP too. So the second that Tinker walks too far forward, he's done for. Arteezy's trying to get the creeps to go in just a little bit. Wants to make his move. There's the cold snap one. Not gonna happen. So Marone able to keep his distance. Arteezy actually taking more shots than he wanted to because he's trying to get this kill. Nice last hits from behind the tower. Up on top, F and Bulba going head-to-head. A little bit of backup coming out of Puppy to make sure everything runs smoothly on the top lane. RTZ still harassing. And now he's keeping the creeps pushed forward so that he can try to get Marone under the tower and keep him low on life. There's the right clicks he was looking. He's still got the cold snap to use when he needs to if he sees a chance to confirm the kill. Meanwhile, Toto gets popped on the bottom. Not a big deal. Eternal Envy doing a good job using orb walking to cause a lot of trouble here on the bottom lane. Again, Arteezy and Marone head-to-head. Marone does get managed to heal himself back up to full. He's brought a lot of regen, including two Fairy Fires, so he knew it would be a tough lane for him, and he was prepared for that. Eternal Envy continuing to use the orb walk and the harass up on top. Meanwhile, we got the Beastmaster putting in a little bit of work. Here comes Puppy, went ahead and got the Illusion Rune, so he'll have those cycle around to potentially scare F back and keep control of this lane. So that's what he's going to do. They're going to come in. They're going to cut Shock Bis a little bit and give a guaranteed farm to Bulba here. Now back to the bottom where Arteezy is in a tough position. He's now on the low ground. So Marone has taken control of the creeps for the first time here. And Arteezy is anxious to get back to the high. He's going to go ahead and use the AMP for that capacity. Takes a nuke, but is misses on the uphill pass. So he's actually now a little bit low. Here they want to move on Toto. Toto dropping low. This will be the first blood. Inevitably well played. And now they want to turn around. They're trying to kill Envy, but Gluttony, what can he do? No, he jumps the wrong way. Would have been worth it for the kill, man. So he deviates off. They lose one. The first blood goes the way of Team Secret. And now Puppy wants to start to play with F. F's going to go ahead and push him backwards, but it's not going to be enough, really, to do any serious damage. He's still doing his job in the mid. Puppy going to get chased around by F here, who's got two Fairy Fires. I think the BIS should change their name to Double Fairy Fire. Strength caught out. Here comes the wraparound. Bulba for the body block. Does miss the block, but he wants to chase. Level 4 axes. This will be death number 2. Here comes BF, though. He wants to put some damage on Puppy. Does the job. Now Bulba on the chase. Wants to keep going. They don't have the ability to dive too far. Creeps are not available. Bulba, though, willing to do it. Going in, he's got the axes. And he finished the job. He's not going to go down. He actually gets out. And the creeps finish off the gyrocopter. What a play. So a quick 3-0 going the way of Secret very, very fast. And while Arteezy's not dominating the mid the way that we thought he would, he's actually dead even in terms of last hits. He's not the one that they have to worry about right now because the rest of the lanes have just been going so strongly in the favor of Secret. 3,000 net worth already on Secret's side as they're just racking up kills left and right. Back to the mid, Arteezy under assault by Marone, who still got those two Fairy Fires on standby. I say diamonds are a girl's best friend, but Fairy Fire makes a tinker's heart fly. And the gold keeps stacking, the items keep pouring in, and Team Secret looking very good so far in this match. Arteezy having a bit of an off day, I think. There's Naruto, he wants to play. He's going cold snap. Marone on the run. Does he have enough? The stun came in. Puppy wants to follow up. Marone in some trouble. Fairy Fire 1. Cooldowns on Fairy Fire, boyos. And it's a good kill. All he needed, Arteezy, was for Puppy to come by and say hello. Marone was so confident because it's going so well. He's not used to supports to show up. And it ends up panning out, paying off dividends. 4-0 as Secret starts to really take the fight to their opponents. Toto on the run, orb walking from the back, little bit of poison on him, Envy thinking about going deep, major move and forces the jump. Meanwhile, up on top, F is farming but having his armor reduced aggressively by Puppy here, who's doing a great job of harassing. He leaves lane and then comes right back. Bulba getting sick farm, 22 and 11 at the moment, 5 minutes into this game. Dire is really starting to fall apart in terms of those last hits, and Voker at 27 and 19, and Tinker just not able to even stay close anymore at 12 and 2. It's like they turned a corner and then all hell broke loose. Hey, Cheesehead. Gold's up to 4,000, XP is at 25. Do a quick item check in here. Let's look out. And okay, so Tinker's going to be going for the rune. Arteezy's on the follow. He's going to use this time to harass Tinker and maybe get a kill. Uh-oh. Tornado to stop. The combo was perfect. And Marone is about to be Maroons. Either way, he did. Bulba takes hits, but has to back away. Ultimately, nothing going on the bottom either, and it is 5-0 as Team Secret continues to stomp forward with the wrath of Khal Drogo's hordes. 4,500, 3,000 XP. Back to that item chart, you can see the Iron Talent on Gluttony is all that he's got. It's all starting to really come together for the boys from Team Secret. Deezy gets hit from behind, takes two shots. Marone, happy to do a little bit of damage, but will it be enough? Meanwhile, on the bottom, they're making another move. They want to get Gluttony. The TP comes out. Gluttony jumps to safety. He says, stop the TP, stop the TP. I got the way. He does, so he's going to manage to escape. In the meantime, B2 continues to try and farm up on the top. He's 18 and 4 compared to the 36 and 11 of Eternal Envy. If there was ever a day where you said to yourself, what's the contrast between a pro player and a mid-tier, even a 5K player, this is where you start to see that contrast come out. It's just the early game mechanics are so much cleaner on the secret guys. When he's throw the tornado, wants to come again. Here comes the stomp. Marone dies to the exact same gank as has happened many times before, and it goes 6-0. Mid is being taken apart systematically by Team Secret. It looks like they might be deciding that it's push time. Pilot Eye going to come from the back, looking to get up a lockdown on F. F's going to hide behind the tower, but he just needs to leave dodge because I'm not sure they can do anything to keep themselves from getting caught out here. Arteezy's now on the chase. Has a tornado up in 3 seconds. Wanted the kill, decides it's not worth the trouble, and we'll go back to the mid position. Unless F comes forward and Arteezy able to spot him. They don't have vision there. Here comes the Tinker. He's going to TPM. Pilot Eye's watching for him, though. Comes out immediately and catches him in the ball. Envy wants to play. There's the silence. Nothing you can do. Marone's caught in the stun again. It's a triple. Marone goes boom, and F's got to run. F trying to take the train out of town, but it's not going to happen as he's burned down. Elder Titan takes the last hit and the mid tower. Boom goes the dynamite, and Biz melts from start to finish. Dire's middle tower. Gold lead 6,000, XP 4,000. They're pushing the bottom, but what's it gonna matter? Net worth charts up for you guys now. That's a 1, 2, 3, 4. Count them, rack them, and know what they are, because that's all Radiant. That's all Secret, and that's why nobody at Opens wanted to have to deal with these guys. Gold lead is up at 7,500. XP at 4.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Arteezy tracking into the trees, looking for a kill. Can't help himself. Decides that they've left, which they have, so they're going to go ahead and just push down this tier 1. All right, it's gonna go down. Now Arteezy and the crew will push up onto the tier 2 without much trouble at all.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Literally, I mean, like, what do they do against them? Gyrocopter coming forward. They're gonna try to make the defense work, but I just don't know how they can do it.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Beastmaster picks off the Tinker on the mid lane. That Marone is literally just getting ripped to shreds. F gets caught by Envy. The silence is out. F wanted to get a call down up, but not going to do it. Tornado will catch two and create plenty of space for Envy to get away. They brought four heroes to top, and not one thing came out of it. And now, they might turn back around.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
But on the Sentry Ward, they do kill the bird. Puppy saw it coming and got out before the invis was revealed. Looks like he's gonna go out there.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
He knows where the ward is, and he's standing just outside of range of it, very cleanly keeping an eye on his opponents. Now, let's look at the bottom where F and Toto are moving Dire's around with Shirt. SDR, they could find themselves in some trouble as the guys from Secret are starting to push up this lane. They want that tier 2. Pilot Eye going to come on, puts up some poison to get some vision.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Now they hold the high ground for themselves. Meanwhile, Puppy goes back to top for the push.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Wahoo! There's the chase. Boy's going to jump to safety. Bulba's going to go ahead and keep farming. He's on his way to Necro Book 3. Once he gets that, all bets are off. The split push becomes a complete reality. Gold lead is over 10,000 now. XP is over 5. Oh, Jack, I know. Rotating down. Looks like he's trying to find someone. There's the someone that they found. And once again, it's the Tinker. No chance. This guy is finding himself consistently picked off, caught out, and burnt down. And it is definitely rough, to say the least.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
He's going to head up towards that top tower.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
There's the dive. They're thinking about going to the high ground. They sort of want to. They've got the Necro books out right now. And they're going to keep pushing. And now they'll head up to the top lane and be objective based. Arteezy is clear out the creeps. Make space for everybody else coming up right now. Eternal Envy on top of the helm of the Dominator. He'll be stacking the Ancients for himself soon. Not that it'll be needed. Puppy doing a good job using the stomp to just stop the creeps in their tracks. Meanwhile, Pile of Die and Puppy, as well as Bulba, are going to go stand inside the jungle and just wait for them to do their job. They weren't planning on coming in. They're not going to reveal themselves until they know what the objective is or how it's being handled and if there's anybody contesting. Thank you. Wait, what hat? Is that better? Moving forward on the center lane. Sorry, my son came over and put a hat on my head while he put one on his, so now wearing a hat on top of my headset. Goldie, by the way, 15,000 XP, 7,500. Holy crap. This game is just becoming all. There was a point a while ago where it became impossible for BIS to win it, and we're definitely seeing that right now. So BIS is sticking together. They don't have the. Jesus Christ, he's level 7? How do you even deal with that? Fudge. Nugging. We're getting to a point where the five position Pilot Eye from Secret is about to become better farmed than the opposing team's carries. Oh, he's already better farmed than the Tinker, and Tinker's just having like the worst game of his life, that poor guy. All right, so Secret's going to push up the bottom lane. I wish I could hype cast for you guys, but there's just nothing to hype. Like, everything's so easy for Secret at the moment. There's the screen, the move. Gluttony ends up going down. He gets riggedy wrecked completely. Now they do the follow-up. They're going to go ahead and take out the Lich and keep coming forward. Arteezy wants to go. He's hitting Marone. He gets pinged out by, it looked like, his own team saying, all right, calm down. So they clear the tower, they'll walk away, probably pick up a quick Roche, I would imagine. That's the safe bet, and then just go ahead and finish high ground. Just like that, it happened. Boom. Pilot Eye, better farm than anybody else on the map. He is more farmed than all of the heroes on the opposing team, including their hard carry. Gold lead is almost 20,000, so they are over 1,000 gold per minute as a team on Evil, on a Secret. 10,000 experience as well. I don't even want to look at the items. Like, it's just, they don't even have that many items. They're just that much better. Dragonlance, Necro 3, Hand of Midas, pretty simple stuff. Rudimentary things here. Necro 3 is gonna come out for the first time. Sarah trying to do a D-ward, gets hit with the poison. Here comes Puppy with the armor D-ward. One, two, three, stop! Down goes Bane without even an official engagement. Lich gets taken out completely. Meanwhile, up on top, Arteezy's like, I'll just handle the split push. You guys gave me the Aegis, it's all good. Puppy with the stomp. Now he's gonna roll up towards, I would assume they'll push mid and top at the same time. Nope, they're just gonna go full balls out. Nope, there it is. So they're gonna push mid and top, both lanes at the same time. Arteezy will take the mid and Envy will take the top, and they're gonna have to commit to defending one and then the other. So either way, you're gonna lose a tower. Question is, who do you wanna lose it to? When you're telling your grandkids about the time that you played Team Secret in the open qualifiers, are you going to say, we lost the Rax to Envy or we lost the Rax to Arteezy? Melee Rax going down. No one has contested Envy yet. They got the Chronosphere. Toto's going to get hit by the split, and Envy's going to 1-2, almost 3-shots him. And now he'll back away as the whole team comes in, but that opens up Arteezy to start laying into this tower. Puppy is playing the security guard role. He'll be sending his ancient up relatively soon. Look at that. Oh my god. F gets killed by Envy. And I'm not gonna lie, he's probably laughing at his computer right now. He's like, I can't believe that just happened. 22,000 gold for Secret, 14,000 XP. And these guys are just really trashing their opponents. This makes me uncomfortable. And stop, they can't even engage on him. F in some trouble, gets caught by the EMP, the stomp. Holy cow! They don't even have to go to the high ground to get kills. Buyback from the gyrocopter, but why? F's gonna come back around. F's getting killed from the distance. He goes down. Chronosphere's got two. Arteezy walks around the inside and survives it. Call down comes out, doing damage. Stomp from Puppy. MVP. Oh my god, it's one, it's two. They want F, they want Rax, they want it all. And they want it now. Puppy's chasing Bane all the way back as far as he can. Bane does manage to get a little bit of a screenplay up to keep himself alive. In comes Morona. He gets caught by Arteezy. Look at this. That boom and boom. A double kill at the exact same time. Envy goes down, but the Aegis was a mere seconds from expiring, so he comes out ahead. Gold lead has hit 30,000 in 19 minutes. That's almost two. That's 1.5 GPM for the entire team, and the GG comes out. Team Secret. Ouch. Good night. Good night.
Dire's middle tower has fallen. Team Secret victory.
Well, thanks for watching, guys. My name's Toffees. Appreciate you hanging out here. But you can find me at Toffees TV. Not much going on the Twitch stream, as everybody seems to be watching the big show. Hopefully you enjoyed what you heard. If you're watching.